Not to this side, I want to measure to the back. It just splits apart because someone didn't tighten the connectors. And there we go. All right, so in order to bend a 90 to get into here, we need to go from this connector out, 90 up, and get into here. So what we need to do is we need to find a common wall somewhere that we can get two measurements for the 90. So this wall right here is good for that. So that's where it's gonna sit. So I'm at 39 inches right there. Then I'm gonna measure from the same wall over to here, and I wanna measure to the back of the 90, okay? Not to this side, I wanna measure to the back because that's where my measurement's gonna be on my bender. So here I have 59 and a half inches. So 39 to 59 and a half. So that's 20 and a half inches. So the next thing we need is we need to know how high the conduit needs to go. What is our dimension from here? So I always start by putting a connector in, get this all the way up in where it's gonna go. That makes it easiest for measurements. And then what I do is I find, again, just like we use that common wall to get this 90 right here, I want a common surface that's close that I can get two different dimensions off of so I can cut my conduit. So here, I'm gonna use this curb right here. So I'm gonna put this where it needs to be, again, to bottom of 90 from here. So from here down to where the back of the 90 is gonna be, okay? So I'm gonna hold this up where it needs to go. It's about 9 inches right there. So 9 inches to 37 and three quarters. I always give myself like an eighth of an inch right here play. So this is actually like 37 and 7/8, but I'm gonna shorten it just by an eighth to give myself a little bit of playroom. 37 and three quarters minus 9 inches is 28 and three quarters. So the first bend that we wanna do is just a little box offset. So we just take the bender like this. I'm left-handed, so you'll probably be holding it like this. Just bend a little bit, flip it, come down on it. Just needs to be a little box offset. Come down. And what I'm doing here is I'm looking straight down the pipe and down the bottom end of the pipe, past the bender, just to make sure they're lined up and they're parallel. And I'm looking at them and they look great. So there's our first box offset. So here we said we needed a 20 and a half inch 90. So the way I think about this, the tip of your tape measure is the start, and where you're holding the tape itself is the finish, okay? This is the start, this is the finish. That's gonna be important here in a second. So take this, put the start of your tape measure at the end of the pipe. You're gonna go 20 and a half right here. Remember, this is the start, this is the finish. You're gonna go 20 and a half and you're gonna subtract 6. Half inch pipe is 5 inches, 3/4 inch pipe, 6 inches, 1 inch pipe, 8 inches. That's the take up when you bend a 90, okay? So here, 20 and a half minus 6 is 14 and a half. That's where we're going right there. What the take up means is that this bender itself, this bender is gonna take up 6 inches as you roll it up, right? So wherever you want the back of your 90 to end, you need to subtract this dimension, actually it's like this, this dimension right here, because it's gonna take up that much to get that 90 right where you want it, okay? So we have this. For a 90, we're gonna use the arrow. Every bender has different marks on it. For a 90, it's the arrow. So we have our box offset. We need to make sure that we're bending the right way. So what I do is, the easiest way to do this is to line it up as though it's on the wall. I know that my offset needs to go straight into the wall for the LB over there, and then I need to bend it straight up. So I'm gonna turn this sideways like this. Before I bend it, I like to take a pencil and just scribe all the way around it. No matter what spot on the pipe I am, I can see it. So I know that I need my offset to go out that direction and bend up. So you line this up. You can set it flat on the ground, and then this needs to be lifted up just a hair, and then make sure that your box offset is lined up. And then flip it up, holding pressure back so it doesn't spin on you. Then we got our 90 right here. We just bend it. I like to go a little bit past the 90. It's always easier to bend back than it is to bend more. So I go like that. I put the bender on the end of it, and I just make sure I have a nice 90. And there we go. And it fits perfect. So now we just take our connectors, Lock them all down, both sides. Please don't forget to tighten your connectors or couplings. Can't tell you how many times I go back behind somebody else and have to tighten couplings, or we're pulling wire and the conduit just splits apart because someone didn't tighten the connectors.